Hi everyone, I'm Faisal and I'm here to talk to you about Dart. Every once in a while, say once or twice a week, I get asked, what is Dart? You know, how do I get started in Dart? And is Dart really a competitor to JavaScript? So let's start off by clearing the air. Is Dart a competitor to JavaScript? Yes and no. Yes, in the sense that it's another way of writing web applications. The goal is not to replace JavaScript. The goal is just to make web application development much, much easier. So Dart is a new web platform by Google created a few years ago to make web development easier. The syntax is very boring in the sense that there's not a lot of crazy sugar syntax like some languages like CoffeeScript have. If you know Java, if you know a C#, if you know even JavaScript, Dart is very, very simple to learn. The other thing is how you get started in Dart. Getting started in Dart is very easy. You just have to go to the website, download the SDK, and run the applications. Now, when you build an application, there's two ways of building an application. One is writing it for the web, as in browsers. And when you do write your Dart application, at the end, it compiles to JavaScript. So it's not competing with JavaScript, it's compiling to JavaScript, in the way because all browsers understand JavaScript. Once it compiles to JavaScript, it runs on all modern browsers. There's no difficulties. It'll run on an iPhone, an Android, it'll run on Internet Explorer up to 10, I believe, and it'll run on all versions of Chrome and all versions of Safari. However, what's also neat about Dart is you can also run on the servers, which means you can write APIs and web servers in Dart. I personally love doing web server development, and on the web server side, it doesn't compile to JavaScript, it actually runs in its own Dart VM. Now the benchmarks on Dart VM are interesting. Node.js is almost as fast as Dart in some aspects, and Dart is almost as fast as Node.js. So they're very neck to neck. It doesn't really matter unless you're writing rockets for the moon. If you want to build really scalable web applications, then go for Dart. In a minute, we'll see how easy it is to get started with Dart and how the language syntax looks like. Getting started in Dart is very easy. Just go to dartlang.org, and here, you'll find a wealth of resources on how to develop Dart applications, how to develop web applications, server applications. You can learn about the language fundamentals here. There's tutorials here. There's a lot of videos from the first Dart Summit. There's a bunch of other stuff here, like DartPad. And DartPad's pretty interesting. The easiest way to get started with DartPad is hit the Try Dart button. As you can see, DartPad is an online IDE to write Dart applications. If I were to hit Run here, you'll see that the output of this code is shown at the bottom. This is really easy when you're developing a Dart application and you don't want to install IDEs, install the SDK, and configure all that stuff. What's neat is that there's instant feedback. So if I write something here, but I forget a semicolon, for example, you'll see at the bottom, there's an error. It expected to find a semicolon. I can hit all right, semicolon, and it compiles fine. I can run it. And you'll see that once it compiles it, you can see that here is shown at the top. If you want to run DartPad in a full screen experience, you can go to dartpad.dartlang.org. Once you've gone past writing DartPad applications, the best way to write Dart applications is use WebStorm or its community edition, IntelliJ. You can get IntelliJ IDEA from jetbrains.com/IDEA, or you can go to jetbrains.com/webstorm, which is the commercial version, though it's not expensive at all. You can hit download WebStorm and use a 30-day trial. And I already have WebStorm running, so we can go WebStorm. And this is a similar ID. If you do Android development, you'll find this very easy. So why don't we start a new Dart application? I go to File, New Project, and at the bottom, you'll see Dart. Here, I have a wealth of resources from console applications to Dart packages, shelf web application, just a general web application with CSS or a Polymer web application. Let's try a web application, call this code to create sample app, and hit create. What this does is uses a tool called Stagehand, and it scaffolds a sample project for you. You can see that I created an index.html, very similar to doing modern web development. You know, it has all the icons that you need to get running on web, mobile, Safari application. You know, just a general boring HTML. There's nothing clever, nothing crazy here. However, if you open up the project and expand the lib folder and the web folder, this is where the Dart magic's happening. If you go to main.dart, this is the entry point for all Dart applications. Just like C and Java, main runs first. You can see that we initialize some nav menus here. We grab our router, HTML5 router, and depending on where we are, it routes it to a certain page. If we go to nav menu, you can see that we're doing some queries, just like jQuery queries, to go ahead and grab the div elements. In JavaScript, you're used to $selector or document.querySelector. Here, we just call querySelector, and it gives you an element. If we run this application, you'll see that we have name reverser, an application that we just built. And if you type in your name here, it'll reverse the name. Really simple, really dumb application, but it really shows you the ease of use of Dart. If you go to reverser.dart, all it's doing is listening to the input for the input element, and every time you enter a keystroke, it calls the method reverse. All reverse does, it gets the output element and assigns it the input element value, but reverse. You can see at the top here, I queried query selector name and query selector out. In my opinion, WebStorm is the way to go to develop web applications. There's also an Eclipse plugin, though it's unsupported now, but there's an open source version on GitHub that a community is actively keeping alive. But I would go with WebStorm or IntelliJ IDE for the best ways to develop Dart applications. So there you have it. Dart is actually very, very simple. If you read that code, you'll see how easy it was to learn. You probably learned the whole language just by looking at a 10-second frame of the code, because that's how simple the language is. And getting started with Dart is easy. Use DartPad to learn it online. Use IntelliJ IDEA Community Edition, or use the WebStorm Commercial Edition. If you want, you can also use the GitHub Eclipse plugin that's open source, though not officially supported by Google. Very easy. Let me know what you think about Dart in the comments. If you have any questions, you can follow me on Twitter at FaisalAbid, or you can follow me on Google+ if you use that, FaisalAbidX, Facebook, or my email is faisal.abid@gmail.com. Thanks. First, let's take a look at the sample app we'll be building. It's a very simple app, and all it's gonna show is hello world and an integer. Sounds really trivial, but if you were to do this in normal Android development, you would have to create a layout file, create an adapter, find view by ID twice,